Yes. Good morning, students. The seventh group elements we already discussed so many topic. Then today we discuss a small topic is there, that is hydrogen chloride. In the seventh group element, of course, the first topic is electronic configuration. That electronic configuration is NH2NP5, outermost 2 plus 5 equals 7. Its IUPAC group is 17th group. This 7th group element is a halogen family. Its IUPAC group is 17th group. Its elements are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine. Here in every group, the last element are radioactive element. After that, we discuss oxidation state. Seventh group element oxidation states are depend upon electronic configuration. Its oxidation states are -1, +1, +3, +5, +7. That -1 are called common oxidation state. That common oxidation states are depend upon zero group element electronic configuration. In every group, common oxidation states are depend upon zero group element electronic configuration. That's why seventh group element common oxidation states are -1. Other oxidation states are +1, +3, +5, +7. After that, if +1 is there, it undergoes sp3 hybridization. If +3 is there, it undergoes sp3d hybridization. If +5 is there, it undergoes sp3d2. If 7, sp3d3. After that, interhalogen compound. Interhalogen compound means when two halogen atoms, they react with each other, are called interhalogen compound. These interhalogen compounds are 4 types: AX, AX3, AX5, AX7. That AX means here, AX means sp3 hybridization, AX3 means 3 unpaired, AX5 means 5 unpaired, AX7 means 7 unpaired. So after that, oxy acids of chlorine. In the interhalogen compound, fluorine cannot form central metal due to abnormal behavior of fluorine. All abnormal behavior of fluorine, that's why fluorine cannot form central metal atom. Oxy acids of chlorine, these are again 4 types. That means, what is the oxy acid of fluorine? In fluorine is formed only one type, hypochlorous. Chlorine is formed 4 types, hypochlorous, chlorous, chloric, perchloric. These all oxy acids of fluorine are formed sp3 hybridization. All oxy acids of chlorine form only one OH. Here hypochlorous acid is linear, chlorous is V shape or bent shape or angular, chloric is pyramidal, perchloric is shape of the molecule is tetrahedral. After that, oxides of chlorine. These oxides of chlorine are again 4 types. That is 1, chlorine monoxide, chlorine dioxide, chlorine hexoxide, chlorine heptoxide. After that, chemical reactivity. These chemical reactivities are in the previous class already discussed. React to water, react to alkalis, react to hydrogen, react to metals. After chemical reactivity, we discuss chemistry of chlorine. How prepare the chemistry of chlorine, which can be prepared from 3 processes we already discussed. The next one, chemical properties of chlorine. Again, it reacts with water, it reacts to alkalis, it reacts to hydrogen, it reacts with metal, non-metal, hydrocarbon, saturated, unsaturated, then reacts to ammonia, reacts to SO2, reacts to carbon monoxide, reacts to benzene. So these topic we already discussed. After the topic, hydrogen chloride, its formula is HCl. Hydrogen chloride formula is HCl. So here, hydrogen chloride, it was introduced by Glauber. How prepare that hydrogen chloride? Hydrogen chloride which can be prepared from NaCl, that react to H2SO4. Now NaCl react to H2SO4, here HCl is remove of HCl, and remaining here hydrogen and here chlorine to get hydrochloric acid. The remaining compounds are NaHSO4. So here hydrochloric acid is prepared. The next, again this sodium bisulfate NaHSO4 again react to sodium chloride. Here HCl is remove of HCl, here hydrogen, here chlorine, hydrogen chlorine to get hydrochloric acid. The other compounds are Na2SO4. These two are methods of preparation of hydrochloric acid. The hydrochloric acid which can be prepared from it was introduced by Glauber. This hydrochloric acid which can be prepared from sodium chloride react with H2SO4 to get hydrochloric acid, and sodium bisulfate is formed. That sodium bisulfate is treated with sodium chloride to get hydrochloric acid formed. These two are called methods of preparation of hydrochloric acid. The next one, chemical properties of hydrochloric acid. These chemical properties of hydrochloric acids are again following types. In the following type, then first one, water. Here, hydrochloric acid is reacted to water to get this hydrogen is this side, that means H3O plus and Cl minus. Of course, hydrogen is negative charge, H3O plus and Cl minus. The next one, react to ammonia. Hydrochloric acid react to ammonia to get NH4Cl. Hydrochloric acid get water to get H3O plus and Cl minus. Hydrochloric acid get ammonia to get NH4Cl. The next one, aqualisia. Here, aqualisia means 3 part of hydrochloric acid and 1 part of nitric acid. 3 part of hydrochloric acid, 1 part of nitric acid is called aqualisia. Aqualisia means 3 part of hydrochloric acid and 1 part of nitric acid is called aqualisia. This is chemical properties of hydrochloric acid. Chemical properties of hydrochloric acids are, then first one, water, second one, ammonia, third one, aqualisia. The next one, fourth one, here Na2SO3. In this Na2SO3, that react to hydrochloric acid. Here sulfur is there. This sulfur, we get sulfur dioxide, and here hydrogen is there, we change to H2O. That means Na2SO3 react to hydrochloric acid to get NaCl, SO2 plus H2O. Then at the same time, here Na2SO3 is there to get NaCl, and SO2 is formed. But calcium carbonate is there to get CaCl2CO. H2O is common. Then again here you need to see O2. HCl. Here carbon is there. That's why carbon dioxide. And sodium is there. NaCl. Hydrogen is there. H2. Then sodium bicarbonate. React to hydrochloric acid. To get any here NaCl. Carbon is there. Carbon dioxide. Hydrogen is there. Water. Simply this one. Na2SO3. React with HCl to get NaCl, SO2 plus H2. Common, calcium carbonate. Here carbon is there, that's why carbon dioxide. Calcium is there, calcium chloride. Hydrogen is there, water. The next one is Na2CO. Na2CO3 nothing but in this Na2CO3 carbon is there, that's why carbon dioxide. Here also carbon there, that's why carbon dioxide. This is chemical properties of hydrochloric acid. This is chemical properties of hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid, it was introduced by Glauber. Here, hydrochloric acid, there are two preparations there. That is, sodium chloride react to H2SO4 to get HCl. There are HCl plus NaHSO4. Again, this NaHSO4, sodium bisulfate. That react in HCl to get HCl plus Na2SO4. This is preparation of hydrochloric acid. Properties. These properties are following types. Water. Hydrochloric acid is undergoes hydrolysis to get H3O plus Cl-. Ammonia. Hydrochloric acid reacts ammonia to get NH4Cl. Aqueous. Three parts of hydrochloric acid and one part of nitric acid to get aqueous. The next one, Na2SO3. Here in the S is there, that's your sulfur dioxide. Carbon is there, carbon dioxide. Sodium is here, sulfur and sodium is there. Sodium get NaCl, sulfur get sulfur dioxide. Hydrogen get water. Calcium to get CaCl2. Carbon to get carbon dioxide. Hydrogen is there, water. Sodium is there, that's why NaCl. Carbon is there, carbon dioxide. Hydrogen is there, H2. In this one, sodium is there, NaCl, carbon, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen, water. So this is chemical properties of hydrochloric acid. The next one, a small topic. Next, a small topic that is general properties. Basically, these general properties are following type. In these following type, then first one, atomic radius. Here atomic radius means, just remember here, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, then oxygen. In this one, atomic radius, from fluorine to iodine. Fluorine atomic number 9, chlorine atomic number 17, bromine 35, 53, like that. That means from top to bottom atomic number increases. When atomic number increases, atomic radius also increases. That means when atomic number increases, atomic weight also increases. So that means, what is the reason? The differentiating electrons enters into next higher energy cells. The differentiating electrons enters into next higher energy cell, suggesting it has less predominant bond of chlorine. This is due to screening effect by inner d orbital. So this is atomic radius. What is the definition of atomic radius? From top to bottom, atomic number increases. When atomic number increases, atomic weight also increases. Due to reason, the differentiating electrons enters into next higher addition, suggesting it has less predominant bond of chlorine. This is due to screening effect by inner d orbital. For example, if you discuss 6-2 group element, if you discuss 6-2 group element, now, if you discuss 6-2 group element, that 6-2 group elements are oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium. Here, if you discuss 6-2 group element, from top to bottom, atomic number increases. When atomic number increases, atomic weight also increases. What is the meaning? The differentiating electrons enters into next to higher addition, suggesting it has less predominant beyond of sulfur. So here seventh group element, the from top to bottom atomic number increases. When atomic number increases, atomic weight also increases. The differentiating electrons enters into next higher addition, suggesting it has less predominant beyond of chlorine. This is due to screening effect by inner d orbital. Here also same thing. For example, if you discuss 6-2 group element, from top to bottom, atomic number increases. When atomic number increases, atomic weight also increases. The differentiating electrons enters into next higher addition, suggesting it has less predominant beyond of sulfur. This is due to screening effect by inner d orbital. This is atomic radiance. The next one, physical state. In these physical states, here fluorine chlorine is the gas. Bromine is the liquid. And iodine is the solid. This is physical state. What is the physical state? Here physical state, fluorine chlorine is the gas, bromine is the liquid, and iodine is the solid. The next one, electron affinity. Electron affinity means the amount of energy released when an electron is added. Neutral isolated gases happen. Next one, electron affinity. Here electron affinity means the amount of energy is released. When an electron is added, neutral isolated gases atom. Neutral isolated gases atom are called electron affinity. These electron affinity means when when electron is added, neutral isolated gases happen. Are called electron affinity. In this electron affinity, the halogens are high electron affinity element. So among them, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, chlorine is the highest electron affinity. So that's why chlorine is highest electron affinity. Cl2 is greater than, F2 is greater than fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. This is electron affinity. So in this one, what happened? The amount of energy is released when an electron is added. Neutral isolated gases atom are called electron affinity. These electron affinity, the seventh group elements are high electron affinity. So in the among the electron, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, the chlorine is the highest electron affinity. Its order is chlorine, bromine, iodine. The next one, electronegativity. Electronegativity means, so what is the definition of electronegativity? So here electronic activity means the tendency of an atom to attract to share pair of electron. It is a diatomic molecules are called electronegativity. This electronegativity, halogens are formed high electronegativity. Halogens are formed high electronegativity. These halogens, halogens are formed high electronegativity. Among these high electronegativity, fluorine is formed highest electronegativity. Fluorine is formed highest electronegativity. So this is electronegativity. Electronegativity means the tendency of an atom to attract to share pair of electron. It is a diatomic molecule. It is a diatomic molecules are called electronegativity. Of course, seventh group elements are highly electronegative. Seventh group elements are high electronegativity. So here fluorine is from highly electronegative element. Fluorine is from highly electronegative elements. Next, color. Here color means here color. Here fluorine. Fluorine is a pale yellow color gas. Fluorine is a pale yellow color gas. And fluorine is a green color. Here green yellow. And fluorine. Bromine is a red in color. And iodine is a violet in color. And iodine is a violet in color. So this is completely seventh group elements. So what is the general in this 17th group element? The last one of the topic is general properties. First, atomic radius. What is the atomic radius means? In the atomic radius, from top to bottom, atomic number increases. Of course, fluorine atomic number 9, chlorine 17, bromine 35, iodine 53. So that means what happens? From top to bottom, atomic number increases. When atomic number increases, atomic weight also increases from top to bottom. So what is the reason? The difference, the differentiation between, the difference between the, that means fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. From top to bottom atomic number increases, gradually atomic weight also increases from top to bottom. The differentiating electrons enters into next to here in this cell, suggesting it has less predominant beyond of chlorine. This is due to screening effect by inner DR. For example, if you discuss sixth group element, in the sixth group element, from top to bottom atomic number increases. When atomic number increases, atomic weight also increases. Reason what is? The differentiating electrons enters into next to here in this cell, suggesting it has less predominant beyond of sulfur. This is due to screening effect by inner DR. Next one, what is physical state? Here fluorine, chlorine is a gas, bromine is the liquid, iodine is a solid. The next one, electron affinity. Electron affinity means the amount of electricities. When an electron is added, neutral isolated gases are called electron affinity. Of course, seventh group elements are from high electron affinity. Chlorine is the form highest electron affinity. Its order is, that's why chlorine, bromine, iodine. Electron affinity is cannot be determined by directly. Electron affinity is cannot be determined by directly. It can be determined by Born Haber cycle. It can be determined by Born Haber cycle. It can be determined by Born Haber cycle. This is electron affinity. Electronegativity. Its definition is the tendency of an atom to attract to share pair of electron. It is a diatomic molecule. It is a diatomic or homoatomic are called electronegative. The halogens are highly electronegativity elements. The highest electronegativity elements are fluorine. The next one, color. Fluorine is a pale yellow. Chlorine is a green yellow, bromine is a red in color, and iodine is a violet in color. So this is completely seventh group element. Its marks weightage is 8 marks weightage. So now these are completely discussing some of the group element. Now finally, we can touch just the boundaries for all topic. What topic we discuss in the seventh group element? In these seventh group elements, first electronic configuration. So what is the electronic configuration here? Seventh group element electronic configuration is NH2NP5. That means its IUPAC group is 17th group element. So its elements are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, arsenic. The next topic is first electronic configuration. Next one is oxidation state, and third one is interhalogen compound, and the fourth topic is oxy acids of fluorine. The next one is oxides of fluorine. The next one is chemical reactivity. After that, chemistry of fluorine. After that, chemistry of fluorine. What is hydrogen chloride? The next one, general properties. Hydrogen chloride. Next one, general properties. After chemical chemistry of chlorine, after the topic development, hydrogen chloride. This hydrogen chloride, it was introduced by Glauber. How prepared that hydrochloric acid? Sodium chloride and H2SO4 to get HCl plus NaHSO4. This NaHSO4, NaCl to get HCl. That means in this one, here HCl is removed. The next one properties, react water, HCl react water to get H3O plus Cl minus, ammonia, react to ammonia to get NH4Cl. Aqua regia means 3 part of hydrochloric acid and 1 part of nitric acid is called aqua regia. The next one, Na2SO3, in that sodium is there, that's your HCl. Sulfur is there, SO2. Hydrogen is there, water. Your calcium is there, CaCl2. Carbon dioxide, hydrogen, water. Yes, sodium chloride, carbon dioxide, hydrogen, water. Here also same thing. Sodium is there, that's NaCl. Carbon is there, carbon dioxide, hydrogen is there, water. General properties. Atomic energy means the difference from top to bottom, atomic number are increases. When atomic number are increases, atomic weight also increases from top to bottom. This is due to the differentiating electrons enters into next to higher energy cell, suggesting it has less predominant bond of chlorine. This is due to screening effect by inner d-orbital the physical state. Chlorine is a gas, bromine is a liquid, iodine is a solid. The next one, electron affinity. The amount of energy is released when an electron is added. Neutral isolated gases atom are called electron affinity. And what happened? Highest electron affinity is chlorine. Its order is this one. Electron affinities cannot be determined by directly. It can be determined by Bohr-Haber cycle. Electronegativity, the tendency of an atom to attract to shared pair of electron. It is a diatomic molecule or homoatomic molecule or electronegativity. Highest electronegativity is fluorine. Color, fluorine is a pale yellow and chlorine is a greenish yellow. Bromine is a red color. Iodine is a now a small topic, that is anomalous behavior of fluorine. Anomalous behavior of fluorine. Next one is anomalous behavior of fluorine. Here, what is the anomalous behavior of fluorine? Fluorine does not exhibit positive charge. Fluorine does not exhibit positive charge. That means fluorine is cannot form plus one oxidation state. Fluorine is cannot form plus one oxidation state. It show minus one oxidation state. It show minus one oxidation state. Fluorine is cannot form plus one oxidation state. It show minus one oxidation state. While other elements are plus 1, plus 3, that means plus 5, plus 7. That means fluorine cannot form positive oxidation state. 1 oxidation state. Otherwise, other elements are plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, plus 1. Next one. After that, in this one, fluorine cannot form positive oxidation state. It can form minus 1 oxidation state. Why? Other elements are plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, plus 1 oxidation state. This fluorine is a small size. This fluorine is a small size. In the fluorine, options of D are there. In the fluorine, options of D are there. This fluorine is a highest electronegativity. Fluorine is a highest electronegativity. Here, fluorine has only 2 electrons. Fluorine has only 2 electrons in fluorine has only 2 electron in penultimate cell. Fluorine has only 2 electron in penultimate cell. Here fluorine react to xenon. Fluorine react to xenon. That means fluorine react to inert gases to get xenon compounds is formed. But other elements cannot react to inert gases. Fluorine react to inert gases to get xenon compounds is formed. While other elements cannot be react to inert gases. This is anomalous behavior of fluorine. Anomalous behavior of fluorine. Fluorine cannot form positive oxidation state. It can be formed minus 1 oxidation state. While other elements are plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, plus 7. Fluorine is a small size. And fluorine is in the fluorine options of D orbital. Fluorine is the highest electronegativity and fluorine it has 2 electrons are penultimate cell. In the fluorine options of D orbital. So this is completely 7th group element. This is completely 7th group element. Next class we discuss about noble gas elements. Next class, we discuss about noble gas elements. So, this is 7th group element. This is completely 7th group element. Okay.